described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
ANNENBERG Learner presents International Trade. For whose benefit?
Nobody worried too much about the first Japanese cars to reach the United States. It was the heyday of the gas guzzler. As the nation's largest consumer of steel, of glass, of rubber, the auto industry drove the economy. And since the days of Henry Ford, the American auto industry kept its hand on the wheel and its foot on the accelerator. Detroit sold the big car, and American drivers bought it. High gas mileage didn't mean much to people used to 30-cent gas.
A tank fires a shell, which hits its target.
1973 changed that. War in the Middle East and an oil embargo were followed by short supplies, gas lines, and skyrocketing prices. Higher gas prices made Datsuns and Toyotas look a lot better.
In a Toyota dealership.
To some, importing Japanese cars meant exporting American jobs. So why not just cut imports to save jobs? For drivers, cars are transportation. But in Detroit, cars are jobs, good jobs, and lots of them. For auto workers, more imports would mean more layoffs, often permanent layoffs, and a search for new work by men and women who had spent their lives on the assembly line. President Douglas Fraser of the powerful auto workers union took the workers' case to Washington. His members and their employers needed protection from their Japanese competitors. Protecting auto workers and the auto industry made little sense to believers in free trade, like economist Robert Crandall of the Brookings Institution, a Washington think tank.
I rather think that the protection for workers in that industry defeats the purpose. To the extent that we protect those workers and protect that industry and keep an umbrella over their prices, their profits, and their wage rates, there's no incentive for them to reform.
But on Capitol Hill, worried workers swung more weight than eminent economists, especially with Detroit Congressman John Dingell, chairman of the House committee which sets import rules.
Almost every country has quotas on importation of Japanese automobiles. The French say that they can bring in any number, but only 2 or 3% will leave the dock. The Italians allow in 2,300. The British allow in approximately 10%. Germans approximately 10%. The Japanese, however, will set up automobile industries around the world in the full expectation that those automobile industries, as well as their own, are going to be exporting into the United States. So I felt it was absolutely necessary in view of the grotesquely unfair trade practices of our trading partners, especially the Japanese, that real quotas and domestic content requirements equal to those of other nations should be laid in place by the United States.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.